Hello, welcome to the Bangsamoro Short Film Festival Film Talk Series. My name is Andrei Nikolai Pamintuan. I'm the creative director of Pineapple Lab, which is an independent space in Poblacion, Makati. I'm also the festival director of the Fringe Manila Festival, which happens every February during Philippine Arts Month. We are currently live on the Facebook page of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority member and festival executive producer, Attorney Maisara Dandamun-Latiph, and the YouTube channel of the Bangsamoro Short Film Festival. Of course, this is the first session of the Bangsamoro Film Talk Series, whose goal is to inspire and educate aspiring filmmakers on the important elements of fiction and nonfiction filmmaking. This talk also aims to stimulate the creative thoughts on how to make compelling visual stories. And of course, today's guests are veteran filmmakers, Direk Marlon Rivera and Direk Baby Ruth Villarama, who we will be talking to later on, just in a few minutes. So the Bangsamoro Short Film Festival was established to reinforce the existing skills, talents, and the knowledge in filmmaking of the Bangsamoro youth, to promote the rights of children and youth through responsible media, filmmaking, and the arts, to discover new artists that will strengthen and widen the camaraderie of the Bangsamoro people within and outside the provinces of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao, or BARM, and of course, bringing the Bangsamoro people together through the arts. All right, and now we would like to welcome the executive producer of the Bangsamoro Short Film Festival. She is currently a member of the Parliament of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao. She is a former Bangsamoro Transition Authority Commissioner, Senior State Solicitor under the Office of the Solicitor General, Head of Educational Program of the Department of Education, ARM, and a Chevening alumni. Let's all welcome Attorney Maisara Dandamun-Latiph.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala barakatuh. Welcome to our first ever Bangsamoro Short Film Festival Film Talk. This is brought to you by the Office of MP Maisara Dandamun-Latiph from the Bangsamoro Transition Authority. As you know, our office, the Bangsamoro Transition Authority, is one in promoting the rich history of the Bangsamoro people in terms of culture, arts, and heritage. And filmmaking is just one of the most potent vehicles that we can use in order for us to promote our cultural heritage. And our office initiative, the Bangsamoro Short Film Festival, or BSFF 2020, is an avenue to give opportunity for young Moro artists in the Bangsamoro, as Andre said, thank you very much, Andre, to enhance and showcase the Bangsamoro's talent and skills in the lens of short filmmaking. As they become directors, videographers, video editors, sound designers, and actors in their own hands, this will also promote awareness on the Bangsamoro stories that illustrate our rich heritage as well as our unique identity as a Bangsamoro. It has this uniqueness has needs to be shared to the whole world and even to this nation. Our aim is really to discover aspiring young filmmakers in the Bangsamoro who can contribute to building a just and inclusive, peaceful society and community, especially during this transition period, where we are in a post-war building context, recently established Bangsamoro government. So we want as much as possible all our young people to join us in building this inclusive, just, and peaceful society. Through this festival, it is our aspiration, it is our hope to provide a platform for you all, young aspiring filmmakers, and even not so young aspiring filmmakers, to showcase your talent and skill in short filmmaking. And we are assisted here today by no less than great talents in this field, in this genre, Director Marlon Rivera, and of course, Baby Ruth Villarama. fellow Shevner. Thank you very much, Derek, and thank you very much, Derek Marlon, Derek Baby Ruth, for joining us today for this film talks. And of course, Andre and Raiden. Thank you very much.
All right. Maraming salamat po, attorney, for that amazing introduction. Of course, we would like to do a shout out to the festival director of the Bangsamoro Short Film Festival, Moro documentary filmmaker, Mr. Radem Musawa, who's an amazing friend of ours at Pineapple Lab and Finch Manila. This event would not have been possible without our festival partners, the Czech Republic Embassy in the Philippines, the British Council Philippines, Department of Foreign Affairs of the Philippines, Fringe Manila Art Festival, Para sa Sine, Bureau of Cultural Heritage of Bangsamoro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao, the Asia Pacific Film Institute, and Save the Children. All right, so thank you so much for joining us. Again, we are live right now on Facebook and YouTube. All right, without further ado, I would like to introduce everyone to our two guest speakers. As mentioned earlier, our first one is Mr. Marlon Rivera, a blockbuster filmmaker and award-winning director and advertising genius. He is known for directing Ang Babae sa Septic Tank and My Little Boss Things. He also produced and wrote for TV shows, films, and advertisements and commercials. Our second guest is Ms. Baby Ruth Villarama, who is an award-winning documentary filmmaker known for her film Sunday Beauty Queen. She is a former member of the NCCA Cinema Board and the Ang Docu Film Festival. She is now a member of the Directors Guild of the Philippines, Incorporated. Ayan, so hello po, welcome, mga direct natin.
Good afternoon.
Thank you for inviting us. It's an honor for us to be here.
Maraming salamat din po. Before anything else, I guess we have to start with how are you? We are in the middle of a global pandemic. So just a quick little check-in. Kamusta na kayo? Bilang mga tao, bilang mga director?
Baby?
Ako ba mauna? Ang daming nangyayari. Surprisingly, we're very busy at the moment campaigning, you know, for the Interguild Alliance protocols na pinaghirapan ng community for the past 3-4 months while we're in lockdown. Naging busy rin tayo sa pagtulong sa lockdown cinema for raising funds for our film workers. And then the Daang Docu na na-postpone nga. I think 2 days before our opening night, biglang pinasara ang UPC ni Adarna at sinabi sa amin na canceled ang festival nyo. So, umikot ang puwet namin nun. Sorry for the word. But, so now we're discussing, we're back in the drawing table and, you know, downstreaming our programming and down the line, kung kailan medyo maluwag na ang diwa natin, we're launching the Daang Docu Film Festival soon. So, medyo busy, but I'm dancing between anxiety, fear, and, you know, just being brave to do what's necessary and to repurpose my whatever skills I have to help the community at this time.
Thank you so much, Ms. Baby Ruth. Kayo naman po, Direk Marlon, no?
Ganun din, parang kay Baby Ruth, kung kailan walang trabaho, napaka-busy namin lahat ngayon. Lahat nga kasi ay tumutulong, nagtutulong-tulong para matugunan yung mga pangangailangan ng, of course, ng film workers, ng teatro, ng live events. Ganun din, parang libre, active ako sa mga grupo, sa mga guilds, no? Tinatag yung aktor, yung League of Filipino Actors, kasama ako doon. So, sinama namin ang boss namin doon sa pagsuporta sa Interguild Alliance protocols. Nandun din ako sa Film Workers Unite. So lahat kung saan kailangan, nandun kami ngayon. Tinuloy ko yung pagtuturo ko, yung lecturing ko, tsaka yung consultant ko, syempre sa Zoom, kasi wala naman tayong face-to-face na mga ginagawa ngayon. So, as Baby Ruth said, kahit nakatirmi tayo sa bahay, hindi nagpipirmi yung ating pag-iisip, yung ating diwa, yung ating kagustuhan na makatulong sa iba o para humingi ng tulong din sa iba. So, ganun. Walang trabaho pero busy po kami ngayon.
walang trabaho pero madaming trabaho, no? And I think that's true for many artists who kind of are reflecting and finding purpose or repurposing their skill set during this time. And speaking of artists, no, madami tayong mga aspiring artists na nanunood ngayon, especially from the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao, and a lot of them are interested in filmmaking. So I guess with anything, we wanna begin from the start. We would like to know your journey. Very briefly, if you can share with us how you got started in filmmaking. Anyone can answer.
Ako na muna. Sige, ako na muna. Yeah. Ako na muna. Matandang una yung senior. Una yung senior.
Go.
Una, hindi ako nagsimula talagang gusto gumawa ng pelikula. Gusto ko magpunta sa sciences. Kaya lang na-expose ako sa pelikula as a teatro muna. At nakita ko yung power ng nasilaw ako sa limelight. Gusto ko yung artista. Pero hindi naganap, no? Nagpunta ko, nag-aral ako ng communication arts instead. Kasi nga, ang kwento nung kapanahunan ko, walang pera sa pelikula, mahirap maging artist, so nag-advertising ako. So habang nasa advertising ako, papalit-palit, naging production designer, nag-AD ako, nag-makeup ako sa pelikula. So kumbaga kahit napaka-torturous at napakalayo ng journey ko, pabalik-balik din ako sa paggawa ng pelikula, no? Napunta ako sa TV, and so on and so forth. And finally, so hindi dapat kayo mawala ng lakas ng loob na it's too late to go to do cinema, because I started to do a film when I was 40. So when I was 40, I became a producer for Cinemalaya with Chris Martinez in 100. And then 2 years after that, I did my first film, which is Ang Babae sa Septic Tank. So ang haba-haba ng prosesyon, pero doon din na uwi sa kagustuhan gumawa ng pelikula. So don't be discouraged that you might be too late or too young. In fact, you can be a filmmaker at any age in your life and you can start anytime you want.
Wow, tama sabi nga nila, keep your eye on the prize. If your eye is on the prize, it will lead you there no matter what happens. All right. So thank you for sharing that, Direk Marlon. What thank about you, Direk Baby Ruth naman? Anong journey natin so far, no, to get to where you are right now?
Nako, mahaba, masalimuot na journey. But I'm really inspired to hear that Marlon started at the age of 40 to make narrative films, which is, you know, it's a testament that it's never too late to start to follow your passion. Actually, for me, I'm a regional filmmaker. I come from Baliwag, Bulacan. I grew up in, you know, in a small town na walang internet, wala pang cellphone. So what we have, a small television lang, wala pa kaming cable noon. And that was the only window I have to be curious about the world. Since, you know, every Saturday may pinapalabas na National Geographic Channel, parang 30-minute documentary program. And I was amazed and mesmerized by the quality of these documentaries, you know, animals telling their stories, na napakaganda ng paggawa. And sa akin, parang I got that curiosity to know the world a little better and to go outside the box that I was in at the moment. So parang iname ko yon. It became an aspiration to travel, to film, to do stories like that, to be a voyager, parang ganon. Kaya nung nagkaroon ng pagkakataon to study journalism in school, parang mas mahilig ako sa moving images than to write. And then since mas gusto ko lang yung basic na, you know, dealing with people from all walks of life, yung mga nasa talaylayan ng lipunan, mga animals, parang nag-gear ako towards non-fiction type of filmmaking. And then sinundan ko lang yon, but hindi siya madaling proseso. Kasi I started from the bottom. I started as a transcriber. I didn't start as a filmmaker. Kumbaga ako yung nagtatranscribe ng interview ni na Cez Drilon, nung mga ni Ms. Corina Sanchez sa Channel 2. And I did that for 6 years before, you know, I was given the break to be a researcher and to be a segment producer. Until a National Geographic project came in through Yam Laranas. And he got me as part of his research team. And then dun na, parang nagkasunod-sunod lang yung mga international co-prod. Pagdating sa documentary, sinundan ko lang yon. Minsan walang trabaho, minsan meron. So, ganun lang ang buhay. Laban lang.
Laban lang. I think yun ang ating key takeaway sa inyong dalawa in terms of how you guys get started on filmmaking. I think a lot of artists, you know, in their journey towards their goal, ang dami talagang pagdadaanan, no? So going to follow up with your passions and your directing careers, we would like to know yung motivation nyo. What motivated you to choose, I guess, fiction for direct Marlon and nonfiction naman. Although you talked about it a little bit, nonfiction for direct Baby Ruth.
I guess hindi naman you can't really tell, no, kung saan ka magpupunta, di ba? Nakikita mo lang naman itong mga bagay nito pag lumingon ka sa likod, di ba? At napansin mo, doon pala ako galing. Doon pala galing yung kagustuhan ko. Kasi, like with Baby Ruth, no, siyempre mas in love ako sa science, eh. So mas aking mas in love ako sa documentaries. Mas in love ako sa documentaries kasi ganun ang aking strong inclination for the sciences. So kaya lang nung again during my time, wala namang masyadong documentary options. This is in the 80s. So ang pwede mo lang puntahan talaga if you want to become a filmmaker or at least a person in the production is to television muna, di ba? So nag-OJT ako sa Regal, ganyan. Napunta ako sa PTB4, naging researcher ako doon, naging PA ako sa mga production, 100 pesos per episode ang bayad for a one-day shoot. Uh-huh. So doon muna ako nagsimula, no? So nag-writer and then second producer. So ganun-ganun nang nangyari sa akin. So hindi conscious sa akin na gusto ko ng fiction or non-fiction. I would still love to do a documentary, except I'm not maybe inclined to, I don't have the temperament for it. Wala yung temperament ko doon. Ibibigay ko na kay Baby Ruth yan kasi siya magaling dyan sa ganyan. But you can never, di ba Baby, you can never tell na wala namang final answer, di ba? Hindi mo alam talaga, there's no final answer eh.
Wala, oo, true.
Walang final answer. So yung pagpunta ko doon sa napunta ko ng teatro, di ba? Nag-direct ako sa theater, nag-act ako sa theater, naging makeup artist sa theater, naging costume designer sa teatro. So ang dami kong, kumbaga, lagi akong nasa mundo ako, nandun ako sa mundong yun. No? So I'm so exposed to storytelling, but I've always been behind the scenes, you know, helping out. Gusto ko maging artista talaga, gusto ko maging dancer, gusto ko maging singer. Pero lagi ako napupunta sa directing, Sa workshop sa CCP, first workshop ko, ginawa kong direktor. Balik akong workshop, ginawa akong direktor. Lagi akong ginagawa ng direktor eh. So sabi ko siguro eventually, parang maybe this is my calling, di ba? So yung kwento naman, sa storytelling naman, napansin ko talaga, mahilig ko sa fantasy, science fiction, mahilig ko sa mga ganyang klaseng mga tema, no? And of course, yung septic tank, ganyan, mga parody, satirico, ganyan. So, and I wish to do more of that. No? Mas gusto ko yung commentary. So may pagka documentary rin siguro yung ganong klaseng storytelling, yung merong obvious na meta or notation about what's happening in the society. Septic tank was like that, diba? It's about filmmaking and the obsession of young filmmakers to win awards, you know, to make a film, to go to the festival. So it's also a commentary film. Eh? So I really like that kind of material. So doon ako napunta. As we've said kanina before, turns over to Baby Ruth, ganun talaga mga anak. As long as you see the mountain where it is, as long as you see asan yung bundok, maglalakad ka doon, medyo ligaw-ligaw ka ng konti. As long as you know where the mountain is at lagi kang papunta doon, you will get there in the end, di ba? So everything that you pick up along the way would be important when you get to that mountain and finally do your first film. No? Even if it takes a long time or a short time, you will need everything you have right now. Yun, parang
ganun. Great. Kayo naman po, direct Baby Ruth.
Nako. I totally agree with Marlon kasi wala namang formula sa buhay eh. I mean, we're all students of life. I mean, nangarap ako maging artista pero parang hindi bagay or you know.
ako din dati.
Diba? Kasi exposed ka sa That's Entertainment, exposed exactly. Ka sa mga GMA Super Show. So parang asaya-saya lang ng buhay, nila pakanta-kanta lang and they're wearing all these beautiful clothes. And akala mo ganun ang aspiration mo. But then, when you get exposed to the realities of life and then hinanap mo yung tinatawag na ikigay, nagkaroon ka na ng reflection sa sarili mo, at kumbaga hinahanap mo yun eh, hindi ko masabing mahahanap mo nga, but all throughout your life, you strive to find that balance, that purpose, to answer what is your purpose in this world, where can you help, what do the people need around you, saan mo pwedeng gamitin yung skills na meron ka, and you have to start from somewhere. I started as a transcriber na nauubos na yung panda ball pen sa kakatranscribe ng mga interviews, and I didn't realize na with my experience in transcribing, dun ko na-appreciate yung art of interviewing and finding the gray areas between silences na napakahalaga sa documentary filmmaking, especially the cinematic language of documentary filmmaking. Kasi hindi lang 5 W's and 1 H yung hinahanap mo eh. We're going beyond the obvious. We're understanding life. And with life so mysterious, may mga bagay na hindi sinasabi na mas interesting. And that's, ewan ko, dun ako nagka-interest. Parang ano ba totoo? The search for truth. Ano ba yun? So, but who knows? Maybe, you know, 2 years from now, I'll be doing a narrative film. But ibang level naman yun. Kasi I'm a fan of movies, pero sabi ko, baka manonood na lang muna ako for now.
Wow, amazing. So I think very similar, may mga similarities yung journey niyo, no? I think both of you really want to delve into social issues, commenting about, you know, the industry or di kaya buhay ng mga tao. And then I think the search for truth and telling stories is quite important for our youth to know when it comes to filmmaking. I'm just curious, no? Hindi to parte ng mga kailangan kong tanong yan, but did the place where you grew up, for example, kind of made an impact into your background as filmmakers? I know you said, Direk Baby Ruth, you're from Bulacan. Direk Marlon, taga saan po ba kayo na probinsya pa, or?
Pinanganak ako sa Iligan, sa Iligan City. So, I've been to Marawi, I've been to Bulacan, I've been to that area. No? Tapos, pero patalon-talon kasi kami, nasa Bulacan, Nueva Ecija.
Uh-huh.
Kung saan-saan ako pinadpad, no, bilang bata. No? So, ako, yes, it affects you. Eh. It affects you. I mean, everything is, everything that you pick up along the way where you're born, is kasama ng consciousness mo, and it's just part of the, kahit hindi ka aware, it's part of your storytelling techniques, eh. It's part of your consciousness. So ganun yung, at least in my mind, importante kung anong saan lugar ka, kasi as a filmmaker, kasi meron kang parang lugar sa loob mo, diba? You have this place in yourself, diba? That's where you're coming from, and that could be a real place or an imaginary place or a history within you, no? So lahat yan kasama, as I said kanina, lahat ng kailangan niyo para maging filmmaker nasa inyo, nasa loob niyo na lahat yan, di ba? What you need to do now as a film is already within you. You don't need to look for anything else. That's why 16, 40, 58, 60, it doesn't matter, because what you have now is already enough to tell something important about who you are. Parang ganun.
Okay, ako rin po taga Pangasinan din po ako. So, pero ang dinidirect ko naman teatro. Kayo naman, oh, wow. Miss Baby Ruth, ano naman po ang parang relevance or impact ng paglaki natin sa Bulacan or sa buhay niyo at sa filmmaking niyo?
Oh my God. Naalala ko lang kasi, lumaki kasi ako sa lolo at lola. I remember my grandmother didn't really want to go to church. Ayaw niya magsimba. Pero in-enroll niya ako sa isang Marian school from kinder to high school, na every Friday may misa, na kailangan magsimba every Sunday. And then yung pamilya ko, parang ayaw nila magsimba. So hindi ko naiintindihan yun. And so parang ako, I'm left to figure out, you know, this religious inclination all by myself. Nagsisimba lang ako. And yet, along the way, there's really more to religion pala than, you know, than letting that religion define yourself. Pero naka-embed yun sa sarili mo, kasi pinanganak kang Kristiyano o pinanganak kang Muslim, wala tayong choice. But as we go on, nandun pala yung going beyond accepting the convention. So bigla ko na appreciate yung lola ko na parang wow, very cosmopolitan pala siya. You know, in thinking na hindi kailangan magsimba every Sunday to be a good person. You just have to be kind. Pero mahabang proseso po iyon. And then also ang Bulacan kasi we're very, you know, traditional in many sense. Pero our personal stories, our bubogs in life will mold our characters eh. Lahat ng pain na pinagdaanan natin, lahat ng questions, pwede mo yung isulat or pwede mo yung going outlet sa whatever creative thing that you're doing. I never had the chance to meet my mom, so that's a missing link in my life. And then later on, I found out that she used to work as a domestic worker. So nagkahugot ako to crave, you know, to define ano bang naging buhay ng nanay ko as a domestic worker. Without, you know, being too self-indulgent naman sa kwento ko. But nireflect ko yun na the story of my mom reflects, you know, so many thousands other Filipinos na may pinagdaanan palang ganun. So again, I go back to my purpose and to that northern light na ano bang pwede kong gawin so I can find my identity and at the same time find some usefulness, you know, with the career that I've chosen.
Wow, grabe, medyo na ano ako sa ano ha, sa mga shinare niyo. I think key takeaways for me and I think for our viewers is according to Direk Marlon, you have to find that place in yourself, you know, the history within you in order to, you know, to make hugot and also to hashtag find those bubogs in your life. According yes. naman to ano to direct Baby Ruth at para honest ang ating storytelling and paggawa ng films. Okay. Ito naman question nato, it's quite general, no? Pero we would like to know your take on it, no? Kung bakit importante ang filmmaking. Why filmmaking is important? You know, in as a society, as people who enjoy films, bakit siya importante?
Oh gosh. Of course, teka muna. Ako kasi ganito, okay. Okay, look at it this way, which I would reflect back to yung bakit nabuo ang septic tank? Bakit nabuo ang septic tank? Kasi nung ginawa namin ni Christian 100, si Chris Martinez yung director, ako yung kanyang creative supervisor at saka kanyang co-producer, dinala namin siya sa mga festival. Nung nasa Osaka kami, pinabas namin yung septic, yung 100, yun si Mylene Dison tsaka si na, you know, she's dying, so she's sa bucket list. Ang tanong sa amin doon sa isang panelist, sabi niya, bakit hindi mahirap yung, ano, yung si Mylene Dison? Bakit hindi siya poor? Ha? Anong poor? Kailangan ba poor yung ano? And I said, why do you say that? And he said that because that's what he kept on seeing about Philippine cinema. I mean, from a foreign standpoint, that's what he saw. He saw poverty as the main depiction of Philippine cinema. So parang ano kami ni Chris, nagpag-reflect kami, and we figured out, we sorted out that maybe because cinema really is the window, at least for foreign audiences, no? Cinema is the window to a nation's life, a nation's soul, di ba? So, ano pinapakita natin, yun ang nabubuo sa kanilang opinion, di ba? Hindi nila ko rin sa Berlin, ang tanong sa akin sa Berlin, bakit German yung ano yung pedophile, di ba? Bakit yung matabang taga-squatter? So, kumbaga, I mean, of course, we have stories about our people, right? But that's what we encounter, di ba? Cinema is so powerful in that way, eh, na parang cinema or even television, that what we see or our opinions, our knowledge about people, usually just come from the screen, from the small screen, di ba? So, nandun mo buo yung stereotype, di ba yung stereotype na nabubuo. Kaya importante kasi, kailangan ikwento natin yung kwento natin, di ba? Because that one image is not, there's nothing wrong with it because it's also true, it must be told. But there are other stories to be told, di ba? Therefore, the more stories that come from us, we should control our stories because these are the things we tell ourselves in the morning that is told about us, about their people. So storytelling is so critical and film and cinema is that tool for storytelling. Ako kasi, ang tingin ko lang naman sa cinema talaga isang, meron siyang sariling medium, meron siyang sariling lingwahe. But it's really just a tool to tell stories, eh, di ba? Para ikwento natin lahat ito. So, yun, sa ang feeling ko ganun, it's super pervasive, di ba? It's super pervasive. Of course, you have Marvel superheroes, and you have DC Universe, and it dominates our landscape. But more so, we must see ourselves. And of course, I would also like to take this opportunity to say that being an LGBTQ person, growing up, I didn't have that image. I didn't see myself represented on the screen, di ba? I had no way of putting together the stories of my life that, you know, would form an opinion about me. I only saw that it's bad, that's a punchline, sinasampal, nilulubog sa drum, gagagawang sirena. So all of that comes from cinema. And cinema are the little stories that we use to tell first stories about ourselves and to find things about ourselves. So it's critical in growing up, forming an identity, in asserting who we are, in everyone's mindset, and so on and so forth. So hindi naman kailangan laging galit, di ba? Pwede namang paborito kong Hellboy, di ba? So hindi naman kailangan laging galit, di ba? Hindi naman kailangan laging seryoso. What I'm saying is, it is extremely powerful, and therefore we must participate in this medium, because that's where we will find, and we will also bring our people into the story, into the table. Kaya ganun ka-powerful ang cinema for me.
Oh, great. So kaya nga ang ganda rin ng event na to, because you mentioned about representation, no? And the Bangsamoro Short Film Festival is to also provide that platform to showcase the voices and narratives of our brothers and sisters at BARM, no? What about you naman, Miss Baby Ruth? Anong take natin sa importance ng filmmaking?
Yeah, just to add to what Direk Marlon shared, cinema kasi is really about cultural imprinting, and also it sets a geopolitical and social kumbaga identity. Dahil ang language kasi ng cinema, ng films, ng moving images, trendsetter siya in a way. Kasi ang mga artists natin, they can imagine a utopic world, a dystopic world, depende sa nakikita. Very truthful ang mga artists. Hindi sila pwedeng magsinungaling kasi soul nila yung nakasalalay dyan. Having said that, whatever we present on the big screen, may impact siya sa mga manonood. So if we present all violence, all poverty, syempre isipin ng mga tao, ganyan siguro ang buhay sa lugar na yon. Ganyan siguro mag-isip ang mga tao doon. And for so many years, we've consumed a lot of Hollywood films. So tayo, pag you know, na hindi pa tayo nakakarating sa New York, ang ganda-ganda siguro ng New York, ang ganda-ganda siguro ng Philadelphia. Pero nung pumunta naman ako sa New York, parang okay, maganda nga siya. Pero marami pong homeless at marami pong madilim at mabaho. Pero hindi natin nakikita sa pelikula kasi iba yung pinakita sa atin nung pelikula na hinain sa atin ng Hollywood. And that's what I'm talking about when there is a need for us to represent our regional stories, especially the Bangsamoro stories. Kasi kayo lang yung makakapagkwento nun eh. Like for me, I'm from Bulacan. Hindi ko alam ang kwento ng mga Bangsamoro. Ang alam ko lang, yung nakikita ko sa news, which is also, you know, moving images, na ito palang nangyayari doon sa Marawi, para ang gulo-gulo. Pero pag nakakapanood ako ng mga short films na iba ang tema, I begin to understand, you know, the cultural identity at saka yung mga nuances ng mga tao sa lugar na yon, which is fantastic and very important. Kasi kung wala yung ganong linkages, kung ano lang yung pinakain sa atin ng mass media, yun lang yung susundin natin. Case in point, like Vice Ganda, every day, marami nanonood kay Vice Ganda, which I love Vice Ganda. And then, nung nagsushoot kami ng mga fiesta around the Philippines, napansin ko, lahat ng format ng mga fiesta host, puro Vice Ganda, parang joke. So parang, okay, kasi napapanood siguro nila. So to them, maybe that's the standard on how, you know, we should really do things when we organize some local live shows in their respective places. So parang interesting yung mga ganong implications. So napakahalaga, every image that we put out, may effect yon sa mind ng mga bata, sa mind ng mga audience natin.
If I may add lang to what Ruth said, yung idea of standard, may teorya kasi sa perception na pag ano yung pinakamaingay, pinakamalaking share of voice, pinaka-constant and consistent, yun ang nagiging standard eh, di ba? So yung mga usapin na parang we only look to one place, it's not about because it's Manila, it's because that's where cinema is made usually for us, di ba? So talagang importante talaga na maintindihan natin na parang, no, that's not the standard. We only see it constantly. That's why we think it is the standard. there should be other standards, diba? And if we want the standards to happen, it is up to us. I mean, it's no one's because that standard will not change. Eh. I mean, you get it will just continue. Kasi ano yan, status quo yan, diba? It self perpetuates itself. Now, if we don't see any other voice, any other stories, any other modalities, any other tono, edi walang magaganap talaga sa atin, diba? That's why a regional decentralization of voices and cinema is so critical, diba? I mean, it's so critical to spread it out. Hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na tigilan niyo nandito yung mataas. What we can do is we can strengthen those who don't have a voice, diba? Kailang balansehin yun eh. Hindi naman pwedeng tumigil ka nga dyan, vice, huwag ka na magpalabas, diba? Hindi mangyayari yun, diba? What we need to do is to, I mean, just an example ah, we need to bring up other voices from all over para magkaroon ng blending, mag-balance ang mga puwersa, ang mga images sa utak natin. So, yun ang parang, don't mistake what you see always as standard because they are not. They're just common. You get it? Iba yung, that's not the aspiration. There's just common. Okay? So, yun yun.
Yes, and it's also a way for Filipino audiences and foreign audiences to embrace the multiplicity of the Filipino identity, no? Dahil ano nga, we have to kind of know that there are multiple narratives and not just one narrative. So actually, you both went into the next question with regards to ano, why filmmaking should be relevant in representing other regions, specifically right now, the Bangsamoro region. I know, Direct Marlon, you said that you grew up in the South, you've been to Malawi. Could you sort of expand that further if you wish?
Okay. Okay. When I was growing up, kasi, so this is Tibanga, no? This is Tibanga, Iligan City, diba? So growing up, I was born in a blended family, meaning my mother is Adventist, Sabadista, yung tatay ko is Katoliko, ang mga kamag-anak ko ay Maranao, di ba? So, kami, magpupunta kami ng simbahan pag Friday may magsisimba, tapos magsasabat na kami ng mga afternoon 3 p.m. Saturday kami magsisimba, Sunday magsisimba yung tatay ko. So, you get it? So, parang, I grew up in that kind of an environment, no? And then, of course, nagbiga rin pala ako. Noong grade 3, nasa biga ako, sa Baragtas, Bulacan. So, biga ako. So, it's right now, this was in the early, you know, late 60s, no? So, can you imagine, it was a very difficult time to be in Mindanao at the time, you know? It was magulo, di ba? I mean, there's a lot of conflict. That's one of the reasons why we left Mindanao, eh, di ba? That's why we left Mindanao. And can you imagine, that's my last image of Mindanao, di ba? Of course, even if I came back, yun ang image ko ng Mindanao, di ba? Na magulo, di ba? Delikado, may tangking dumadaan dyan sa labas ng bahay namin at certain nights, no? So it was a place of conflict. It was a place of conflict. And can you imagine, even at my age, I still view it as an age of as a place of conflict. And of course, happened to Marawi, it's still about conflict and devastation, di ba? So, wala na akong microview, wala na akong view sa tao ng taga doon. Alam yung kwentong tao? Yung buwibili ng something, eh, in love, you know? I mean, I don't have that story anymore. It's just a blanket of one big idea of it was a place of conflict and a dangerous place, and it's now a devastated place. I'm sure it's not true, you know, in the totality right now, at a human level, right? I'm sure they're suffering, but I'm sure there are other stories, there are other kwentos, diba? So for me, even if I'm from that part of the world, I am of the country, even if I continue to have, you know, Muslim relatives, even if I'm in there, even if I still go to Muslim center for palapa, you know, and get all these things, or the dul, or all of these mga things that I like to eat, no, from the South, medyo kulang pa rin sa nuances, di ba? Kulang pa rin sa nuances. Kasi nga, malayo na ako dun sa lugar na yon, di ba? And I really wish I could hear stories again coming from that side. That's not from my relatives or, you know, from my friends, di ba? Sana I can hear more, I see more of what's happening there than just the news, than just the memory that I had, which I think was toxic. You get it? It was a traumatic time. So I wish I could, you know, you know, cinema can heal, diba? Cinema can heal us also if we see it and, oh, we understand. And I hope that, you know, more of these stories will come to really change the whole narrative about hanggang dyan na lang ba ang aming ganaw, di ba? So yun ang sana ang, I mean, for me, that's my wish, no, coming from myself from the South, from Lanao.
Thank you for that. What about you, Direk, Baby Ruth? Bakit importante ang filmmaking sa Bangsamoro region?
I just want to share my experience when we made my first documentary film, which was Jazz in Love, set in Davao, Mindanao. That was my first few trips to Mindanao, and I was able to understand, you know, how the topography of the place, like it's just one solid island, like Luzon. And then when we were doing our research, sinasabi nila that homosexuality is really bawal among Muslim communities. Parang it's a no-no. I don't know. Correct me if I'm wrong. So ako parang okay. I'm not from here, but I want to amplify the voice of our Mindanao kababayan, because Jazz is from the southern part of Davao, Malita. So I use that. Kumbaga, nandun na yung voice eh. Kailangan lang i-harness eh. So whatever, I guess, technological knowledge I got from my studies here and there, in-apply ko siya. And then, I didn't realize na Jazz voice, na napaka-simpleng, you know, tao from this small island in the South, can really present the voice of the LGBT and destroy mediocrity, destroy, you know, hypocrisy on how we view LGBT around the Philippines. And ang tapang ng boses niya. So sa akin, my God, all I had was what, 2 camera na DSLR, and then the platform where you can, you know, magnify this story from the South. So imagine, I mean, that's why this Bangsamoro Film Talks, Bangsamoro Film Festival, it's very important. Kasi platform to eh. The more platform you have, the more window people, you know, will be able to see your stories. Like us, kulang, I mean, I will not say that I'm an expert of Mindanao story kasi hindi naman ako taga doon. But the filmmakers that I've met from the South, my God, iba ang lingwahe nila, iba ang design nila, and I love, you know, the way that they are, kumbaga, interpret their stories. So, iba-iba yan eh. So, ang sarap niyang panoorin. And we learn from each other through that.
Yeah, it's all about amplifying talaga. Amplifying these voices. Ang ganda ng mga sinishare niyo for our viewers. And speaking of your two camera setup, no? ano naman ang ano, how with limited resources, hindi naman agad high-tech, no? Well, how can one start making films or start breaking into the film industry? What knowledge and skills they need to acquire? Is that innate? Is that something that they can train with? Mga ganun bagay.
Alam mo, I mean, I'll start kasi nga galing tayo sa two camera setup. You won't believe that I finished Jazz in Love with 25,000 pesos. Hindi ko alam kung paano nangyari. Ganun siya kaliit. Nanghiram ako ng camera kasi wala naman akong camera at that time. Yung partner ko merong isa kasi nga part siya ng studio. So hiniram ko yung isa, and then yung isa nanghiram lang din ako. And then I collaborated with a cinematographer from Zamboanga, Dexter De La Peña. Tapos nanghiram ako ng lapel from Wild Sound kay Sir Mike Idioma. Tinuruan niya ako kung paano hiram-hiram. And then yung 25,000 piece of fare ng Cebu Pacific papuntang Davao. Tapos tumira kami sa pinaka-chipipay na parang in 400 pesos a night. Tapos kung saan umabot yung 25,000 namin, parang 2 linggo ata kami sa Malita noon. Sumakay kami ng bus. And then we just followed. Kumbaga, we trusted our instinct, we trusted our subject. Hindi kami nag-control. Siguro yun din yung kaibahan ng non-fiction sa fiction. You have to trust outside elements, but you have to be exact when it comes to your filmmaking. Siguro okok ako sa cinematography. Gusto ko maganda, parang Nat Geo. I tried my best na i-capture yung moment. Parang kaming mga nakatanghod lang sa ganyan. Parang maghahalika na ba sila? Ano ba, mag-aawin ba sila? So, you know, we went through that natural process. But yeah, start from the basic, it's okay. Whatever you have. Ang maganda ngayon, may mga pitching sessions na. Kaya ako naman nakuha yung 25,000 ko. Pinahiram ni Mother Lily of Regal Films. Kasi Yeah, sumali ako sa isang pitching ng Cinemalaya. Ayaw pa nga akong tanggapin nun kasi nga documentary daw yung story ko. I think puro fiction yung tinatanggap nila. And then I told Rica Arevalo, sige na, I mean, you know, I'm not expecting na matatanggap, but just give me the opportunity to present. And then, naalala ko na sabi ni Mother Lily, may sex scene ba yung film mo? So, hindi ko alam kung, feeling ko, akala niya siguro nagpipitch ako ng narrative, but anyway, binigyan pa rin niya ako ng 25,000, and that helped me finish the film. And then, I met Tony Gloria, who opened Optima, you know, for color grading and sound mixing. So, kumbaga, network yourself, use the network to work for you, huwag kang mag-antay for the network to approach you. Join, you know, community events, film-related events. Kaluwat ka ng workshop, sumali kayo sa webinar ni Direk Marlon Rivera. You never know, eh. Baka, you know, madismiss, sorry ka, na magkwento ka lang. And then, you know, eventually you'll find the right person to help you. And wag, be humble to start from the bottom, really. Priceless yung experience na yun.
Oh, wow. Starting from the bottom. Ang magandang message yan, no? Walang arte-arte.
Oo naman. I'm sure si Baby Ruth, kung may absent siya, nagagawa, di ba? I mean, ganun.
Yeah.
Ganun yung, kumbaga, kung ayaw mo, ako nandyan. In fact, kung wala sigurong artista, si Baby Ruth talang, I mean, you get it. We can do it, di ba? That's how it's supposed to be. Now, for me naman, may gusto kong, although I will talk about the equipment, I will echo two things that Baby Ruth said. I really wish that you would consider documentary. Okay, documentary. It's not necessarily a science thing, di ba? There is storytelling that happens there. You've seen Sunday Beauty Queen, di ba? So sana, what I like about the documentary format, if you're young, is you're not thinking about, I want to write a story. It's not about that, di ba, Baby Ruth, di ba? You look at things and you say, hey, I'm curious about this. I want to pursue this idea. Kumbaga, you're not trying to create something from out of your head. You're just being sensitive to what's happening and documenting that and putting it together. Kung mahina ako sa transcription, but you know, putting it together and you know, and hindi naman kailangan linear, di ba? Hindi naman kailangan it para siyang thesis statement. So, what I love about the documentary format is that, yes, you know, you can just be patient and pay attention and pursue it like what Baby Ruth did, no? With 25,000 pesos from Mother Lily. Then you can do that, diba? You can do that. So, kasi ang problema kasi sa mga filmmakers kami na fiction, ang stumbling block namin, ano magandang kwento? It takes us so long to sit down, you know, write it out, diba? Kumbaga, even if we take things from reality, it's really trying to create that, you know, that new world, that rearranged world, diba? So sana hindi, it's a different way of seeing things, no? And it's also a different modality for production. So I really, you know, I saw the Dems paglayag and said, wow, ang taray naman may mga water shots. Di ba? I mean, di ba? It's very sophisticated kasi, of course, matanda na ako sa simula. So dumaan ako sa advertising, di ba? So alam ko na yung mga nag-grading na ako. Sanay na ako sa ganun mga kalakaran. But when I did Septic Tank, wala kami ding pera din naman kasi Cinemalaya, di ba? So yung camera namin, depende kung ano ma-afford that day. Alam niyo, gano'n yung parang, ano ba ito? Baricam? P2? Yung gano'n yung, kung anong available that day lang yun ang gagamitin mo, di ba? Or may mga moments na parang, bilisan nyo direct kasi wala tayong ilaw na dala, di ba? So wala kami ilaw na dala, so kailangan mag-shoot pa kami. So pag ginagabi kami sa bahay ni Eugene Domingo, ginagawa namin, we have to shoot everything against the wall para hindi makita mga bintana kasi wala na kami ilaw, di ba? Wala nang sunlight, konti lang yung, isa lang yung ilaw namin. So, pag binomba mo naman ng close-up yon, so kumbaga, mukhang daytime na rin, di ba? So yung mga ganun mga tricks, di ba? So, you can, it's really not about the equipment, eh. It's really about how you do it and if you have the willingness to do it, di ba? Even if you have the most expensive camera and you're not, you know, you're not doing something about it, then it still doesn't work. And the last bit that Baby Ruth said is, I'm a believer in that, in networking. You really have to find people, you have to find your tribe. Kasi pag lumaki ka naman, pag dumating ka na sa mundo namin, you will find out, eh. You'll always have your tribe. Yung sabi na parang, why do you keep on working with those people? Eh, bakit? Love ko sila. No. Kasi natulungan nila ako, di ba? They understand me. Like ako, I'm a very, you know, energetic person. So kailangan ko ng team member na medyo makalma. That's why I like Miss Lee Mailey kasi aking DOP. Kasi she's a very calming influence. kung na-tense, na-stress ako, siya hindi siya na-stress, di ba? Yung, sister, itong gawin natin. No, she's a soft voice eh. So you have to cast even your team, even your tribe, the people around you to make your film happen. You have to cast them. Kasi they will give you some things eh. The honest, you know, the honest person who will tell you na, kapatid, ang pangit ng shot mo, di ba? Yung, you have to have that honest voice as part of your friends. Hindi ka palalagpasin, di ba? Meron kang friend na magaling mag-organize or magaling sa schedule. So, you really have to cast your tribe. Eh. I call them your people, di ba? You have to find your people. And when you find your people, then they will help you move. And they will see you through the most difficult times. And I hope you see them through the success. You know, you share the pain, you share the success with them, di ba? So, importante yung ganong klaseng mindset na you can't do it alone. You can't do it alone. We have to start finding people who will help you through. Diba? Hindi yung financier, ha? Hindi yung ganun. But just, alam mo, minsan kausap lang, diba, Baby Ruth? Yung, may kausap pa lang, may kabatuhan ka lang. You have to talk to someone so you can comment and you can talk about the idea or the shot. Importante may kausap, eh, may kabatuhan because it magnifies the idea. The idea becomes much stronger if someone is, you know, you're talking to someone than just the idea being in your head. Yung parang ganun.
Wow, I feel like ano, ang haba ng pwede nating kwentuhan, ang dami niyong insight. Ang sarap, parang quarantine, guys. okay. So, ano, we're down to our last question actually, no? Ang we didn't notice the time. But ano ang parang gusto nating message sa ating mga aspiring filmmakers those who are based in the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao and all over the world when it comes to filmmaking, especially sa mga ganitong panahon, no? And in times of a global crisis or social upheavals, anong message natin para sa kanila?
Okay, mauna na
ako
para finale si Baby Ruth ito.
Oo.
Grabe.
Naka-pressure kasing last frame, di ba? Ito lang masasabi ko. Una, the only way to learn and to make film is to make film. You get it? Kahit alam mo, nung matanda na ako, ang dami kong theory in my head, ang dami kong nabasa, ang dami kong napanood, ang dami kong preparation na ginawa, which is really, I think it's important. But you only really learn how to make a film if you make a film. You know, once you record something, that's the only time you say parang, oh, that's bad, that's good. That's the only time when you frame it, when you put it in that frame, that's the only time you learn, ganito pala ang sensibility ko, di ba? So, you cannot think about film. If you want to become a filmmaker, you cannot think about it. You just have to do it. You just have to make it, di ba? You have to make films. Okay, that's one thing I want to say. The second is this. There is kasi a myth about a film that it has to be 2 hours. It has to be in a cinema. It has to have 3 acts, you know, 3 acts, di ba? Mayroong mga movements, mga denuma, mga conflict na yan. We are taught so many things about films that are pretty standard. Yung 2 hours length ng film na yan dahil yan sa cinema, sa mga theater yan, di ba? So, kumbaga, do not accept immediately the convention that you are fed, di ba? You can have about two. Hindi makailang a short is what? Hindi ko undermine ang format, di ba? If a short is like what? You want to say 20 or 12 or ganyan? It doesn't matter, right? If the story can be told only in 7 minutes, then that's how the film should be told. It's 7 minutes, right? Hindi mo kailangang pahabain yan para kumasya sa format ng mga tao. So that's the other thing that I want to tell you. The last bit that I want to tell you is this. Aside, we already told you about how important your voices are in this. Being a lone filmmaker or any artist for that matter. I know you can create great art, but cinema kasi is a collaborative art. It's really a collaborative art. You don't know until, I mean, meron ka naisip, pero darating yung PD mo, yung lighting designer mo, or you know, the sky will turn, your editor will come in, your music person can come in. You have to be ready for all these things. You know? You have to wait for all these things. Kasi, if you're too strict about this, the only thing I want to see, ito lang gusto makita, ito lang talaga. And then you need other people's help. You have to consider that they also have something to bring to the team, to the table. So, yung teamwork is so important in film. And that you have to start accepting that fact because you can't do it alone. I mean, maybe you can, but I believe that you have to have people around you. So, yun ang gusto ko sabihin sa inyong mga anak na parang, you do it now, don't do it later, just if it's recorded, it's already frame one. I mean, ilagay mo na, sequence one. Lagay niya sa dope sheet na yan. Na-shoot na yan, di ba? And then find the other part of the story, second part of the story. You just have to do it. You just have to do it. Second is, don't believe that everything has to be in a format of what we see in Hollywood or in star cinema, whatever. No, don't. You can, maybe you'll invent something new for us, di ba? It may be the new ways of telling stories will come from you. And pangatlo is that you need your people. You need your people because it's so lonely to be walking to that mountain. It's so lonely to be doing it alone. But if you have your friends and your team members, you know, it becomes more bearable. And of course, if your film fails in whoever standard, at least meron kang kainuman afterwards, diba? At pwede kayong magdamayan, diba? So you need people to do this. So right now, find already your team. Marry your team with you, okay? So yun ang, especially yung weakness nyo. Anong weakness nyo, hanapin nyo sa ibang tao. Because they will supply your lack, diba? Kung saan ka hindi magaling, hanapin mo mas magaling sa'yo doon. Yun lang masasabi ko doon sa mga bagets na gumagawa ngayon. Do it now and do it with people and throw away the rule book, diba? Malay mo, gagawin kayong bago para sa amin lahat.
Wow! Thank you, Direk Marlon. What about you, Direk Baby Ruth?
Wala, nasabi na ni Marlon.
multiple narratives, di ba?
Oo. Magdadagdag na lang ako na, kasi ka, filmmaking is the ultimate sport. It's a lonely journey, actually. So you have to also reflect upon yourself, the things that, you know, you're willing to sacrifice for. But I tell you, it's so worth it. Kasi legacy mo yun eh. Kumbaga, we're part of a history. We're given this certain lifespan. Hindi natin alam kung kailan yung deadline, kung kailan yung pack up para sa buhay natin. You know, we just have to do our share of that part of history na binigay sa atin. And I know that you already have a voice, and I understand that you may be confused, scared, you know, with all the convention, with all the rules at the moment. Know that, but throw it outside the window after it and follow your heart. Kasi filmmaking is an emotional language and you have to own it. Do not copy. Get inspiration, but own that voice within you. Kasi ikaw lang ang makakapagkwento niyan. Huwag kang mahiyang humingi ng tulong. Join, you know, community events, as I said a while ago. And always love your audience. Yun yung nakakalimutan din natin minsan. It's all about self-expression. Parang, I have this story. I think the world needs to see this. But we also have to consider the audience that we're sharing our stories with. Kung limited lang yung audience mo, fine. If it's within, you know, the Bangsamoro community, know their likes and dislikes. Know what ticks them. Know, you know, the right rhythm that would work for them. And introduce something new. Nasa sa atin yun kung gusto natin silang i-shock, biglain, bigyan ng bagong form. But at least aware tayo na ito yung kapasidad ng audience natin. That's why ganun yung style ng documentary na ginagawa ko. Kasi I want to reach high school students. You know? Gusto ko maintindihan ng high school. Gusto ko matapos nila yung pelikula ko na hindi nabubore. Kasi na documentary siya. So at least aware lang tayo. If we want to introduce a new kind of storytelling, fine. But at least love our audience. Kasi sila yung impact. Eh. They are the ultimate reason why we're doing our film.
Wow, thank you so much. Ang dami kong notes, so parang ako nag-classroom. Oh my gosh, ang saya. Well, thank you so much to our lovely speakers, Direk Marlon and Direk Baby Ruth.
Salamat.
And thank you din to Attorney Maisara for organizing this event along with Festival Director Radem Musawa.
Can I also invite the sure. audience today to submit their entries on or before July 25? And our juries are also no less than Direk Marlon Rivera as well as Direk Baby Ruth. So, ang ating pong office ay in partnership then with FringeMNL at the British Council in the Philippines. Ang ating Bangsamoro Bureau of Cultural Heritage, nandiyan din po siya. Nanood din po kanina yung director nila, executive director, si Arden Sally. Nanood din po ang executive secretary, or yung number two sa buong Bangsamoro region, si Minister Abdul Raouf Makakua, ang Executive Secretary sa Bangsamoro. Nandiyan din po yung ating mga member of the parliament na nanood din. Nandiyan, kanina nakita ko din sila. As well as po yung mga youth na gustong magpatuto ng filmmaking at seryoso talaga. Natutuwa po kami nandito po kayo lahat, pati po ang Save the Children na nag-sponsor po. Don't forget po to share this. Share this very important, you know, gems. Kasi po, I was thinking na may mga rules pala na dapat wag nang i-apply. That is yung rule na do not be conventional. Just follow what your heart is saying and you will never go wrong. Yun po ang pinaka-important, yung authenticity na nakakalimutan po natin sa pagsasabi ng storya. Dahil sa dami na napanood po natin na sa tingin natin ay mga colonial din, no? Na pagtingin, nakakalimutan po natin tingnan na baka meron sa loob ng ating kultura na hindi na-touch ng colonialism na sinasabi, ito lang ang maganda, Hollywood lang. Baka po makadiscover po tayo this time. Sana po with our effort for the Bangsamoro Short Film Festival. Sabi ko kay Radem, baka in the future Bangsamoro Film Academy na yung itayo natin. Important para magtuloy-tuloy na yung effort na to, hindi masayang. So ako po susuporta po kung magkakaroon po ng Bangsamoro Film Academy para po sa future and aspiring talents in the Bangsamoro to tell authentic stories coming from the heart. And always with the audience in mind. As well, sabi nga ni Direct Baby Ruth, and sabi rin naman ni Sir Marlon Rivera, always tell your story. Tell your own story. Yun, wag tayo masyado sa stories ng iba. So, it's better na yung ating stories malaman. At yung nakakalungkot na sabi ni Sir Direct Marlon na bakit walang story for Mindanao na maganda? Bakit yung micro, yung love stories, yung marriage, celebration, yung mga ultimo yung ating daily life, kung paano ang mga relasyon sa Bangsamoro ng magulang at anak, ng mga lovers also, siyempre. Eh, hindi na ikukwento. Ang istorya lang na nakikita ay yung pinapakita ng mass media. Sana po ngayon magsimula ang kwento ng Bangsamoro. Galing sa puso mismo ng Bangsamoro. Maraming salamat po sa inyong dalawa at sana po suportahan niyo po kami dito sa pagnanais namin na maitatag ang Bangsamoro Short Film as well as the Film Academy for the Bangsamoro. Thank you very much,
Direk. Thank you po. Thank you, Radem. Heritage Without Borders with hashtag BSF2020. And please don't forget to submit your films on kailan nga ba yun? July 25, 2020. 25. Yes, exactly. Again, thank you so much to our executive producer, Attorney Maisara Dandamun-Latiph, Moro documentary filmmaker Mr. Radem Musawa, our festival director, and of course Direct Marlon Rivera and Direct Baby Ruth Villarama. This event would not have been possible without our festival partners, the Czech Republic Embassy in the Philippines, the British Council Philippines, Department of Foreign Affairs of the Philippines, French Manila Art Festival, Para sa Sining, Bureau of Cultural Heritage of Bangsamoro Autonomous Region of Muslim Mindanao, Asia Pacific Film Institute, and Save the Children. All right, thank you so much for joining us. My name is Andrei Nikolai Pamintuan of French Manila and Pineapple Lab. Please follow me on IG at Nixipu and at Andrei Nikolai on Twitter. Maraming salamat po. Thank you so much and congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Salamat.
Salamat.
Okay na ba?
Thank you very much, Direk. Okay, okay. Yan, thank wala you na tayo on air.
Kamusta naman kami? Sorry, ang ganda namin.
Oo, oh, ma'am. Ang ganda ng discussion.
Hindi ko alam na si Direk pala sa Mindanao. From Mindanao si Direk. From Iligan po pala kayo, no? Sa Tibangan.